Hello, welcome everybody. Welcome. So if you've ever been to any of our other Shochu Rocks, we are pretty much just going to wait a few minutes and let people pop on. If you have anybody who might be interested in joining, send them the link, send them an invite. Today is going to be the finale. We actually have more than just Kimijima-san joining us today. We also have Nakahara-san and Yamakawa-san. And you'll find out a little bit more about them as we go on. But for now, they're just kind of mystery, exciting guests for you. So right now, I just want you guys to get used to Zoom as we wait for everybody to pop on. Remember that at the bottom of your toolbar, you can see the chat button. Click on the chat, use it. Let us know where you're from and why you love shochu. You also have the Q&A button. So if you have any questions, you can also put them in the chat or using the Q&A function. And just to note, when you're in the chat, make sure you write to all panelists and attendees so everybody can see what you're writing. We don't want anybody to miss out on what you have to say. Mark Goldberg is here. He's always here. We love that. He's such a great support. And he's also the founder of Sake Collective. So we're just going to wait just a few more minutes.
さっきのことなどわからしないぜ勇気を持って外に出てみよう誰だってみんな悩んでるんだ勇気を持って外に出てみよう
I'm not
Right, guys, I think that's enough time. So thank you so much for coming to our finale of Shochu Rocks. So I am Ida Vong. I am a sake specialist and I work for Mutual Trading. Every now and then you'll see me helping out with the Sake School of America. I also write the Sake Splash articles that is available for you guys to read on the Sake School of America website. So please check those out if you have time. but basically, before we dive into everything, I just want to give you a brief overview about how everything will go. I'm sure a lot of you guys are already Shochu Rocks veterans. You've been here for almost every single session. But for those who haven't attended before, basically our host, Ueno-san, will be giving you a quick introduction of our wonderful guest today. And then he will be giving you a crash course on Shochu and what it's about, how it's made. And be sure to take notes because at the very end of this, we will be doing a short quiz where you have the chance to win a Sake School of America Shochu Advisor class for free. It's open to anybody who is here today. So please take notes. And then we will have Kimijima-san, Nakahara-san, Yamakawa-san explain a little bit about the featured products or featured Shochu today and Awamori. And after that, we'll have a nice little kind of break where Naoto-san from Kuramoto Ice will be showing us a cocktail, maybe two if we have time, with Kuramoto Ice and then also using the spirits that we're going to be talking about today. All right, so Ueno-san, please take it away.
Welcome, welcome to Shochu Rocks. Toshio Ueno here. I'm executive instructor for Sake School of America, and which is a subsidiary company of Mutual Trading Company. Mutual Trading Company is a Japanese food and non-food importer and distributor. We are celebrating 94 years this year. And I'm also director of Sake Specialist Division at Mutual Trading Company. This Shochu web seminar was created to promote not so well-known Japanese spirit, Shochu, targeting non-Japanese markets and introducing different ways of enjoying this national craft spirits. For now, this is the last scheduled session, sad, but we'll come back soon. I'm probably having this one theme once a month in the next few months later. And today I have a special guest. I'm so delighted and excited to have Kimijima-san. He's such a energetic, esteemed, spirited Shochu rock star. Kimijima-san is owner and president of Yokohama Kimijima Company, and he's vice president of Japan Sommelier Association. And you just heard his song, Ashita ni Mukatte Hashiro. And his band name is Mystic Waters, and he's a fourth generation owner of liquor store in Japan. One headquarters is in Yokohama, one in the Ginza, and one in Tokyo again in Ebisu. And he travels a lot all over Japan and around the world to find quality sake and wine. His liquor stores, Yokohama Kimijima, is a popular and very famous for quality delicious sake and wine chosen by himself. So if he doesn't like it, he's not gonna sell it. Kimijima-san is well knowledge and connoisseur has earned him a number of titles in wine producing countries, especially in France and Italy. And so restaurant hotels trust his selection of wine and sake. He also holds lots of events such as seminars on sake, shochu in Sydney, London, Paris, New York, with many sake makers. Actually, he was the one who did a seminar for WCT at the first time before they started doing a sake education. He was the first one to do the lecture there. Yokohama Kimijima is a long established liquor store which started in 1892, but that was a little bit different and he changed the whole concept. Now he sells more quality sake and wine and shochu that he only approves that quality. And also some of them are not so well known. He discovers those undiscovered quality spirit sake and introduce them at his place. So here comes our today's shochu rock star, Satoshi Kimijima-san. Please.
Thank you.
あ、
どうも。
紹介お願いします。
あ、今上野さんから紹介されしていただきました君島さとしです。
My name is Kimijima, Satoshi Kimijima that 上野さん has just introduced for me.
普段ワイン、日本酒、焼酎、ウイスキー、いろいろ酒のいいものをとにかくや売ったり、もちろん飲んだりしてるんですけども。なんかワインと日本酒も大好きなんですけど、その本当になんか疲れたりとか、なんか元気がなかったりとか、なんかちょっと失敗したりとか、そういういろんなへこんだ時にいつも助けてくれるのは焼酎なんです。でだから今日焼酎本当にもう本当に思い入れがあって、で今日特に素晴らしい3つの焼酎を紹介したいんで、今日はよろしくお願いします。
So as the fourth generation president of Kimijima Shoten, the company that he has a retail store, but you should understand that in Japan, when you have a retail store, you're also the wholesaler. So naturally, he has tried and sought out many, many wines, sake and whiskey, other things a lot. He's definitely tried a lot, but whenever he has a roadblock in life,or is really facing difficult times, shochu really has been his soulmate. So he's really excited to show you three really sought out, very unique products that he found that is not as well known to introduce to you today. Hey.
では。
And really quickly, I just want to introduce Sachiko Miyagi-san.
Sorry, I just jumped in. I'm Sachiko, I'll be translating.
No, yeah. Sachiko-san will be translating for us today. All right, take it away, Una-san.
So now I'm just going to go through the basic information on shochu. Really quick, like 10 minutes.As you have seen on previous slides, the shochu is a Japanese spirits and it is a distilled alcohol beverage. Sorry, I am not doing this one right. Hold on.
Sorry, one second.
Sorry.
Zoom difficulties.
Zoom difficulties, is this good?
There you go.
Oh, yeah. So, distilled spirits.And distilled only one time a pot still, and has to be made with koji malt. And the five main ingredients are sweet potato, barley, rice, brown sugar, buckwheat. History of shochu is started from around 16th century in Japan, or even though, distilled alcohol beverage existed in China in 13th century and 14th century in Thailand. So,I think in the 15th century, we started, distilling the shochu, but only written record evidence in Japan was found in temple in Kagoshima region, prefecture, where two carpenters, both are brothers, working for renovating the temples, and they wrote that a complaint saying the monk was so stingy, so he didn't serve them any shochu.So that was, only evidence we have from the as a text to show that, when the shochu was existed in those days. So it was 1559, so that was 16th century. And, two brothers was just complaining. So if they found that a wooden piece underneath of that the roof that they're trying to renovate. So that's that. And, Kyushu,As you can see on this map, Kyushu is the southern part of Japan, and 77% of the shochu and amori is made in those regions, Kyushu and Okinawa regions. The biggest one is Kagoshima, and next biggest one is Kumamoto and Miyazaki and for the rest of the places follows. And as you know, it's a warm and humid climate they have. And it is affected by typhoon every year, a few times in summertime, springtime and summertime. That's why, you know, it is really hard to harvest, you know, like rice on the west side and the east side of the Kyushu Island. And also back in, you know, back in 1732, there were severe famine. That people died from starvation, and the sweet potato was introduced to, you know, save the world, save the many lives in Kagoshima region. And also, you know, especially in Kagoshima region, it's really hard to grow rice because there's a volcano, Sakurajima Island is active volcano still since 1914. So ash is on soil, it's very hard, but the sweet potato you can grow really well. And next slide, we show you how Japanese or Asian alcohol beverage is made in different ways than Western. And this shows you, this slide show you, shows you that, you know, wine is a single fermentation alcohol beverage, and beer and whiskey is multiple fermentation, and also sake and shochu is multiple fermentation too, but Western world and Eastern world has a different saccharification means, you know, converting starch to sugar, as you can see in here. For Western world, they use malt. So you have to make a malt. Malting is you put the barley in a humid, warm condition that it will sprout. When the grain, the barley grain sprouts, inside of the grain will produce enzyme to convert the starch to sugar and become maltose. Maltose is a, you know, sugar. And then you dry up those malts, and then you put in a different tank with water and yeast and other ingredients to make a beer or whiskey. That's Western way of making alcohol beverage. But for Asian, and especially in Japan, we use koji, which is a microbe or mold. And what it does is breaking down the starch to sugar. That's their job, very similar to mold, but it's a different strain, it's a different thing. It's a mold, fungi. And then those conversion of starch, we call saccharification, making sugar. And alcohol fermentation takes in the same place at the same time. So we call them multiple parallel fermentation. See, Western one is a sequential, one by one. So we call them single line multiple fermentation. That's the biggest difference here. And then, you know, koji mold. We have different type of koji mold. We have yellow koji for sake, soy sauce, miso, and also shochu. Some of the shochu, one of the shochu today we are tasting is made with yellow koji, because yellow koji was used way before black and white koji in Kyushu Island, except Okinawa. And then you have black koji, just Aomori we call them. It's black and it has savory, earthy, rich, complex flavor. And you have white one. That's this is discovered by Dr. Kawachi. He was trying to find very active enzyme spore, active enzymatic spore in there. And he found a white one, and he took it out of the white one by itself and inoculated by itself and become a white koji. Right now, many shochu makers use more white koji than black koji, but the most popular shochu in Japan right now is using black koji. People start liking more complex, savory, earthy, more rich flavor. So that's that. And it's, you know, of course there is a difference, but you know, there's so many way of making shochu. There's there's so many steps. So depending on what kind of distilling you do, what kind of mash you use, but for authentic shochu, we call it honkaku shochu, is distilled only once by pot still. Okay. But old one is not pot still. You will see that new, the old traditional still called kabuto, kabuto distillation pot later on. You'll see that too. And then there's two types in distillation machine. One is atmospheric. This one's normal pressure, meaning it is, you know, nothing is its usual one. So the distilling temperature or boiling point of alcohol is 85 to 95, but you have a new one, which was found in 1973 or something, that the one with the shochu maker started using reduced pressure distillation machine. So this is vacuum. So you suck the pressure by vacuum machine. So the boiling temperature of that alcohol is getting lower. Like if you're going up to the mountain and boil the water, boiling temperature is low. So you don't have to, you don't really burn the mash. So it gives you more clear, lighter flavored shochu. And that's enough from me. And now the Kimijima-san's gonna start talking about next. We're gonna have three shochu. So this today, it's gonna be a little bit longer than usual. I think it's gonna go over 1 hour. Usually we try to finish in 1 hour, but this time, since Kimijima-san's here, since, you know, the maker of the shochu is here, many makers, owners and presidents are here, it's gonna take a little bit longer. So I hope you will enjoy. And here is Kimijima-san, Sakurayama-ka. Chanan.
そしたら君島さん、商品の紹介をお願いします。
はい。では最初の、焼酎、泡盛という沖縄で作られている、焼酎なんですけれども、
So the first one we're gonna introduce is from Okinawa. It's called 泡盛。Go ahead. 以上です。
はい。泡盛は普通かけ米とかって普通一時仕込みのほかに、かけ米するんですけど、麹全部麹だけで1回の醸造を1回蒸留するっていうシステムですね、これは。
So what's unique about Awamori, within the category of shochu or distilled spirits in Japan, is that it is made with all koji.And so instead of adding steamed rice to the fermentation, it is all koji. And in this case, it's using a black koji king.
はい。泡盛っていうのは世界の蒸留酒でですね、最初に出てきた時はすごく割と安いものなんですけれども、それを熟成させるともう今コニャックとかウイスキーの高いやつよりも高い値段がつくくらいに、とにかく最初の、新酒はすごく安いんですけど、これが例えば20年30年40年寝かしたらもう、50万60万70万とかそういう値段がついてしまうぐらいに、非常に、寝かした時に価値が出る、蒸留酒なんです。
So 泡盛When it first comes out as a shinshu, that's a new batch. So without aging, it's a fairly affordable beverage. However, when it's aged to 30, 40 years or so, the price of it skyrockets. It can easily be apparently $5,000, $7,000. So it's a spirit that really...gains its value by aging.
それで この桜山川というのはですね、初めてなんですけれども、この山川酒造、後でまた社長を紹介しますけれども、この山川酒造っていうのはそのステンレスタンクに、沖縄でも唯一というくらいに古い古酒をステンレスタンクに入れてずっと何年ものものをお持ちの古酒をすごく持っている蔵なんです。
So this、product that he is going to show us today is from Yamakawa Shuzo, and they're dedicated to aging their product、in stainless steel tanks. So they're one of the makers that have、so much aged、awamori in-house, and he's going to、show us one of the products there.
まあ、それでですね、そのやっぱり寝かしてあるものはやっぱり1本10万円とかしてしまうので、そういったものに近い味をどうやったら作れるかということで、一応考えました。
So these aged products can easily be over $1,000. But what Kimijima-san really wanted to do is make something that is、accessible to the masses so that you can enjoy and、have a taste of the flavor of these really expensive and unique products.
それはどういうことかというと、ここで15年寝かしているもの、まあ、毎年寝かしてるんですけど、そう大きいタンクに入ってるんですけども、それを14年、15年、14年、13年、12年、11年、10年、要するに15年から5年までの11年間を均等に 9% ずつ、11年、99%、また 100% にするようにして、均等に、11年間のを一つに合わせます。
So what they came up with for this product that Kimijima-san produced、is to blend the kusu.Is what、aged awamori is called、from age 15 all the way down to age 5. So they blend an equal amount of each of those years and then offer it. So they're all at、44% alcohol by volume.
それでですね、普段はですね、大きい亀をで仕込んだり熟成させたりするんですけども、本当に沖縄にはですね、もう昔からシャムっていうそのいわゆるタイから、来たですね、シャム南蛮っていう本当にその魔法の亀みたいのがあって、まあ、一応こういうものなんですけども見るかな、
The photo that they're showing us,、he's showing us right now, is of an earthenware that is more traditional、aging ware in Okinawa. So even though Sakura、or Yamakawa Shuzo, they age most of it all first in the stainless steel tanks, they also have an aging method in these earthenwares、that are traditional and especially called shamunambang.Which is a special、earthenware from Thailand. And、it's sort of really sought after and told that if you age it in that, it's like magic. Everything becomes really, really、amazing. So that's the photo that he was showing us.
そのシャムナンバンのいいシャムナンバンっていうのは本当にもう結構ほとんどもう沖縄にも残ってなくて、10本は残ってないっていうふうに言われています。沖縄自体にもですね。で、そこに1本この山川酒造に実はあるんですね。その山川酒造にそこに入れるだけで本当に古酒が見違えるくらいに見違えるというか、本当にすごくいいフィニッシュができるっていうことなので、これを44度のものを取っといて、そこに、2ヶ月寝かすんですね。で、2ヶ月寝かしても2ヶ月間でこのボトルで40本ぐらいしか取れないんです。だからその本当に貴重なんですけれども、この 亀で寝かし最後にフィニッシュをすることによってまたこのブレンドしたやつがまたさらに一体となっていくんですけれども。
So they first blend all the aged almoni from year 5 to 15, and then they put it in this earthenware called shamunamban, which there's probably only 10 existing, and Yamakawa Shizuo has one of them. So what they do is they age it in that earthenware. You saw that they're a little bit smaller.So they age it in this magical earthenware for 2 months, and they're only able to get about 40 bottles of this product every year.
はい、本当にこの口に入れた瞬間、そのハーモニーっていうか、本当になんか交響曲というか、そういうような感じがあって、
交響曲、
シンフォニー。
A symphony.
Symphony,
right. So he just puts it in his mouth and there's this amazing symphony that comes out. It's just this, this balance and this sensation of harmony is incredible to him.
それで余韻もずっと長いのでこの、まあ、その世界にですねこの今まで日本の焼酎っていうのは日本人が、まあ、日本の焼酎が海外に行ってるのって大体日本人が飲むような焼酎で25あるんですけどでも私たちはやっぱ世界に本当に焼酎のいいもの、いわゆるもう蒸留酒として最高のものとして広めていきたいということでですからその素晴らしい最高のジンだったり最高のウォッカだったり、最高のウイスキーだったりブランデーのいいのやつとその辺と同じような飲み方をしていただきたいということでこれは本当にお食事の最後に、飲んでいただいてもいいですし、まあ、いろんな飲み方してもいいんですけど本当にこのフランス料理の食後酒としてのこのワゴンに乗ったりということができる数少ないこの、焼酎だと思います。
So he would love for you to enjoy this at the end of the meal, the French meal, anything. So the reason all of these products he's showing us today for him is about showing the world how amazing shochu can be. And being on the platform of like this world spirit. I have smelled this product and have tasted it and it smells like sherry.It is amazing. It has an amazing aftertaste, Kimijima-san was saying. And it's something, it's a spirit that really can stand to other like world renowned digestif and other spirits.
And really quickly, we actually have a question from Mark Goldberg. How many liters do those pots hold?
シャムナンバンって何リットルぐらいの
あじゃあこれをですね今日ここに、はい、山川さんのこれを作ってる社長が参加してますので、
はいはい
社長に登場してもらいましょうか
Okay, great question.
山川さん
I'm going to ask the president of this brewery 山川さん who has joined us today 山川さん
それとねスライドの中に今シャムの南蛮カメが
シャムの南蛮カメの Yeah, so the slide has the シャムの南蛮カメ
30リットルぐらいかな
About 30 liters or so 山川さん、このシャム南蛮は30リットルぐらいの青森を入れられる大きさですかねごめんなさい、ミュートされてる
ミュート
できます。First of all, Yamakawa-san, thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, hello.
今回はありがとうございます。はい。
はい、そのシャムナンバーは。
山川社長。
はい。
あ、My name is Munekuni Yamakawa. I'm a president of and CEO of Yamakawa Shizuo Distillery.Thank you for inviting me to this Zoom meeting. So if you have any question, don't hesitate, ask me. これ以上日本英語喋るとあのボロが出るの
いやいやいや、通訳いらないです。
はい、元気が山川さん、はい、先ほどのあの加盟なんですけど、シャムナンバーは弊社にも1個しかなくて、33リッター入ります。
So the シャムナンバー earthenware, it holds 33 liters. They only have one in the company.
どんどん説明してよろしいんでしょうか。
はい、はい、
33リッター、33リッター、
33
リッターで、あの先ほど君島社長の方からもお話があったんですけども、40本っていうのは国内販売720ミリリットルで約40本を取ってまして、
33 liters equals 720 milliliter bottles, about 40 of those. ごめんなさい。
アメリカ輸出用としては36本しか出してないです。で、あの、so. 極端に言えば、これは君島屋さんにしか出してなくて、世界で36本しか出てないお酒です。
So, and for export, there's only 36 bottles imported to...America, which means just to the world, and he's doing that especially because he has this relationship with Kimijima-san.
はい、で、これも先ほどご説明あったんですけども、少なくともそのシャムナンバンで5年から15年までのお酒を2ヶ月ですね、多い時はもっと3ヶ月とか5ヶ月の時もあるんですけど、少なくとも2ヶ月以上は寝かせてから出荷しましょう。ということで作った商品です。
So when they developed this product, they said, let's put it in the Shamunamban earthenware for at least 2 months. It depends. Sometimes they put it in there for keep it in there for another month, so 3 months total. But they're committed to that quality of minimum two months aging in a special earthenware.
桜山川っていうのは、まあ、あの弊社のある蔵が沖縄県の本部町っていうところにあるんですけども、でそこで日本で一番早い桜の花見祭りが開催されます。まあ、桜一番っていう商品もあるんですけど、この商品もそれにちなんで名付けた商品です。
So the name is Yamakawa. So this is from Yamakawa Distillery, and Sakura means cherry blossoms.So the city that they're in within Okinawa is where the first cherry festival is conducted. So, and with Okinawa being the southernmost islands in Japan, that means they're the first to celebrate the arrival of cherry blossoms in Japan. So that's why they named it Sakura Yamakawa. They have a few other products that have the name Sakura.In it because of that.
Sakura Yamakawa に関しては以上なんですが、すいません、あのこの今映ってる画面の、
はい、
Founded in 1967って書いてるんですけど、創立は1946年です。
は
い、1967年っていうのは、私ども一番古いお酒が1967年ものっていうのがあります。
あ、はい。1946年。So I'm sorry, we have to update this slide where it says founded in 1967. 1967 is the year that their first product launched, but they were actually founded in 1946.
1967年は一番古いお酒が1967年蒸留のお酒があるということです。
Oh, okay.So, sorry, 1967 means that the oldest aged kusu that they have, the aomori that they have, is from 1967. So that's probably where the year came from. So that's their oldest aged product from that year.
ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。で、その
ズームのあのバックグラウンドは、その蒸留所の写真ですか?
バックグラウンド右側のですか。 の、
はい、山川さんの後ろに写ってるの。
ああ後ろに写ったのこれバーチャルで入れてるんですけど、そうです、
はいはいはい、
蔵の写真です。はい、
Nice. So, yes, so he has a Yamakawa Shizo. You can see the little sign, but that's the distillery in his background. Very, very blue sky, Okinawa appropriate. We have the... Are you what number is it? What
is
it? The one on the left of the picture is the Shamu number.
Ah, yes.
ここに映ってるのはシャム南蛮じゃないんですよね。
あ、違うんですか。
このあじゃあ、ここにこの山川酒造のところに看板に亀が入ってるじゃないですか。これ、看板に。山川酒造の看板にここに。これは違います
よ。仕込みです
か。あ、これが違いますよ。はい。ごめんなさい。これは違いますよ。はい。
これは販売用の亀。販売用の亀。
It's different from the シャム南蛮。私、質問していいですか。そのシャム南蛮の亀はずっと受け継がれて、家にもう1946年からあったものなんですか？
いや、これはですね、多分ちょっと同じ、あの、蔵のある町は本部町っていうんですけど、本部町って言っても誰もわからないんだから、チュラウミ水族館
の
町
です。チュラウミ水族館の町。ノースエリアね。
はい、沖縄の那覇空港から車で2時間ぐらい北に向かったところにあります。北ですね。
So they're in a city called Docho, which is about 2 hours north by car from Naha airport when you fly into Okinawa.
はい。そこであの、あの、古酒造りの名人の方がいらっしゃって、その方からちょっと私の記憶が確かであれば、あの、譲り受けたみたいな話を聞いてますので、創業当時からあったものではないって聞いてます。
So my question was about how they got a hold of this really amazing sought after chamnamban earthenware. And he said that he's not like completely sure of the origin, but he's heard that there's a master of Aomori ager, aging person, and that they were given...the earthenware pot sometime after 1946, so sometime after the distillery was founded. ありがとうございます。
一つ質問なんですけど、あの沖縄で古酒のことをクースっていうじゃないですか。
はい。
発音はなんどんな発音するんですか？
アクセントまで正確に言うとクースです。
クース。
クースじゃなくてクース。
クース。
Okay.
So, Ueno-san's question was, when we say kusu for aged Aomori, what is the pronunciation for them? And he said, I hope I can repeat it. He said, actually, it's
kusu.
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 Yes, perfect. Yes. Thank you, Yamakawa-san, for joining us and showing us
the
product. Thank you. Thank you.
はい、では2つ目のお酒なんですけれども、
okay, going on to the second one.
明治波頭火。
It's called 明治波頭火。
これはですね、明治時代にその焼酎っていうのはですね、室町時代からお酒を焼酎作られています。
So, 焼酎 as Ueno-san mentioned, it was about 15th century or so, 16th century, when shochu was starting to get made, which is like Muromachi period in Japan.
それで、明治時代に文献が、明治時代の文献が、焼酎、その昔から明治まで、それですね、どういうふうに作られてたかっていう、今はその、まあ、麹は麹、かけはかけって、別に仕込むんですけども、まあ、一発でその麹もかけも一緒に仕込んでたりとか、あと玄米で、その今は白米でやってるんですけども、玄米で麹を作ったり蒸したりとかするっていう、そういう本当に昔の文献に基づいた昔の焼酎を復活させたのがこの明治波頭火でございます。
So those of you who've taken shochu advisor, you know this, but there's making shochu normally by default is a two-step process where you make the first batch of fermentation and then you add the main ingredient. But in the old days, it was made all in one fermentation batch and also made with brown rice instead of polished rice. So this Meiji Hatto using a process from 400 years ago. So according to the some records, they've decided to revive the really, really, really old school original method of making shochu from brown rice.
ちょっと簡単に説明しますと、まずこの昔の作りっていうのは、木麹ですね。今白麹とか、黒麹とかなんですけど、この木麹で、要するに、本当にブラウンライス、玄米で 100%、そして仕込みはこういうちっちゃい、どんぶり仕込みって言って、このちっちゃいものに、その玄米が麹、蒸して麹をつけたものと、これを炊いたものを、玄米を一気にここで仕込みます。
So if you can see on the slide and what Kimishima-san's holding, they use 100% brown rice. They make the koji from brown rice. They also add steamed brown rice to it. They use a yellow koji, which is, has been around longer than black koji and white koji. And they also make the batch in this one-step batch process in this, if you can see the wooden barrel where the person is mixing it by hand, it's that size. So it's super labor intensive process.
それでですね、この、それをできた、お酒をこの蒸留するんですが、本当手作りのこういう兜釜蒸留っていう、こういう直火で炊いて、本当に手作りで昔の焼酎を再現して、これ1回の仕込みでできる焼酎は4合瓶35度で、わずか50本しかできない。
So one batch, they can only make 50 bottles of the 720 milliliter size. This kabutogama, this, the illustration in your, on your screen, is a super old school distillation method. So to this day, today Meiji Hatoka is distilled with fire. So they actually have to control that fire, and that affects how things are distilled. There's a video that you can watch about this, but the distilled spirit comes out of this bamboo stick. It's cool to watch. Very small batch. It's a kind of crazy method.
それをまたタンクで寝かしてから出荷するんですけども、本当にこのテイスティングすると、本当にこの、米、すごく上質な米の感じが凝縮して、この香りにあります。
So then you age it for 5 years, but when you taste it, for Kimishima-san, it has this concentrated, really good brown rice quality to it, or rice quality. I can tell from looking at the photos that this brown rice is なんかこの玄米透き通ってますよね、写真で見ても。
はい、
そうなんですよね。So、はい、really, it's from an area that's known for rice production that was protected for hundreds of years. So they have very nice water, very nice premium rice made there.
それで
So funny that, you know, we had last two bottles, Sakurayamaka and this one,in our office, and you know, I had like one cup of the one half of the glass of this boss shochu, but now I start, you know, preparing for this session, I found out there was like only this much left. I was like, what happened to the thing? And you know, I think everybody came here and, you know, start drinking and they liked it. So that's how much it was good.
Sakura Yamakama もそうなんですけど、ジハとかも、
この時しかない。
オフィスにサンプルのボトルが あるんですけど、本当にすぐなくなってしまうっていうのも、ああっていう感じなんです。
そうなんですよ。
This is very true.
だから自分も食事でちょっと飲んだらもう一昨日お肉と合わせたんですけども、まあ気がついたら35度あるのに半分は飲んでるんですよね。もう。
The kimchi must I had this with meat two days ago, and it's even though at 35% ABV, he was really surprised. He like almost finished half of a bottle himself.
で飲み方としてはそのもちろん食後酒でもいいんですけども、まあ、お水と5対5で割っていただいて、そうするとまたこの独特のこの焼酎からまたいい味が出てきたりとかして、そうすると食中にも飲めますし、本当にそのまま飲んでもいただいて、これをおかんするとまた美味しいんですよ。温める。
So as far as drinking like suggestions, of course straight is delicious.You can also have it with water, so half and half water. You can also warm it up. That gives it another impression. He recommends it all different ways, and with food, and also as after the food, so as a digestive.
Smoky.
Yes.そうですね、アーシーな感じもあってすごい。なんかそうモルトウイスキーに共通するような感じだったりとか、こういうのが焼酎でも味わえるっていうのはやっぱりすごいなと思いますね。
There's like a depth of flavor similar to malted whiskey. So to be able to experience that in shochu is something that he really wants.
You know, this region has been damaged by, by typhoon a couple of days ago, and many over there are suffering, and this same as this distillery too. But, you know, we feel really sorry, but...We can do is, you know, he's gonna have a Shochu Paradise song later on, his song. If you sing that song in the karaoke in Japan, that money that he's gonna earn, he's gonna donate all that karaoke earning to the Kumamoto regions for recovering from this disaster, by the way.
So, a very sad topic, but this is one of the.Distilleries that was damaged in the flood that started last week. Yes.
So, 今日本は日本だけじゃないと思うんですけども、世界中が予期せぬ、天候が急に急変してものすごい災害があり、本当に先週の土曜日、今日が金曜日だから本当にもう数日前に、予期せぬもう大雨がこの九州地方に、一気に来てしまって、それも前日大雨が降るっていうような情報が入ってくるぐらいに急な大雨だったんですけども、でそこでこの、大和石さん、この大和石酒造さんはその人吉市の川の近くに蔵があるんですけども、そこで一気にですね、その、球磨川という川が氾濫してしまいまして、それで、まあ、下田さん、今、そのやっと連絡、昨日取れた時には、もう本来ならばここでお話をしてもらって、こう説明してもらおうと思ったんですけど、とてもそんな状態じゃなくて、事務所、店、工事室、製造室、瓶詰めのライン、ボイラー、しかもこのさっきの蒸留機まで全て、沈没、もう水に浸かって、しかもこのカブト川上流は流されてしまったと。で、どこ行ったかわからないということでございます。で、まあ、 本当に数軒隣の人は亡くなっている状況で、まあ、一番今回の大雨で一番被害を、まあ、遭ってしまって本当に心苦しいんですけども、まあ、なんとか、まあ、昨日やっと連絡取れてクラウドファンディングとかしないのって言ったら、もうそこまで考えられないと、家も今泊まるところも使っちゃってないという状況なので、そこまで考えられないですけども、でもぜひね、そういった時があったらみんなで協力したいっていうお話はしたんですけれども、でも本当に、まあ、その佐田さんのところもその鹿児島もそうなんですけども、どこに当たるかわからないっていう、それがこっちの方に関東に来れば関東の蔵も非常に恐ろしい。だから今コロナでこんなに世界中が、すごく大変な時期に、またそれに追い打ちをかけてですね、この水害だったりで、またあの、また台風の時期にも入ってないんですけど、台風がまた来たらまたそれはそれで、毎年毎年その想定外の台風だったり想定外の雨だったりですね、本当になんか世界中がちょっとおかしいんですけど、まあそこをなんとかですね、この焼酎のパワーで乗り切っていきたいなと思っております。
So, he realizes in the recent years this is happening all over the world, but these natural disasters really hit unexpectedly. So this really heavy rain that went through Kyushu starting last week,They heard that there was going to be some heavy rain like the day before. And then this brewery is actually, he just got a hold of them yesterday, finally. But all of their dwellings, so their home is underwater. You see photos, if you look at the news, of just seeing the roofs.The Kapotokama that's in this slide, the traditional kama, they don't know where that is. It's washed away. We had asked them, Kimijima-san has asked if there's any crowdfunding or anything we could do to help. They're not quite there. They need to figure out, you know, where they're going to stay. So it's a really devastating time. It could hit anywhere, really.And I guess the scary thing is that it happened so sudden. Kimijima-san really hopes that, you know, during these hard times we're dealing with corona pandemic and natural disasters on top of that now. And we really hope that shochu is going to help us get through these times. And we serve these beautiful products that we are lucky to enjoy.
Hi. ただ昨日連絡取れたら、明治8日の熟成してるタンクは多分無事ではないかっていうふうに言っておりました。他のもろみは結構タンクが結構流れちゃったりとか倒れちゃったりしたんですけど、この明治8日のタンクは多分大丈夫じゃないかっていうことはおっしゃってました。
So a lot of their tanks, are gone or, not in commission anymore, but they suspect that maybe the Meiji Hatoka, this product's tank, aging tank, might be okay. That was the word yesterday when Kimijima-san was able to get a hold of them.
ですから、まあ、本当に、まあ、一日も早く復活してほしいですけども、やっぱ彼がこんだけ一生懸命その焼酎を作っているのを、やっぱり我々も含めてですね、もっと早くこういうのをまあ、伝えなきゃいけなかったんですけども、本当にこう早く伝えられなくて本当に申し訳ないなと思っておりますけども、いやこんなにここまで頑張っているっていうのは本当にちょっと本当すごいなっていうのは、またその一本ゆっくり飲んでみて初めてこの心に伝わるというか、なんか焼酎とかって気酒してたって一瞬でその味はなんかわからないなと思って、やっぱりこの一本をちゃんと飲んで初めてこの凄さがわかるっていう感じがいたしまして、これからはきっちりと伝えていくようにいたしますので、早く復活していただきたいなと思っております。
So he realizes that, you know, maybe this Zoom, he wishes he was doing this kind of stuff to show the heart and the work and everything that goes into making this these types of products, this Meiji Hatoka and others. But he really hopes that you get a chance to sit down with a bottle, because kikizake is just tasting. Of course, it's amazing, but you don't get to feel the soul as much. You don't get to get intimate with it. And that's really Kimijima-san's wish, that we all get to sit down with these amazing products and really appreciate it to the core. He hopes to continue to provide information and show, like, introduce these important products. So he says, yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Thank you, everybody, for joining.
Thank you.
One thing I want to mention about this is, you know, some of the students ask me about Kastori Shochu. You know, this one is very unique because they they put kasu, moromi kasu, and on the top, on the sieve or drainage board, and then you have moromi itself, and they distill at the same time. So you can see in that, in the middle picture, showing that. So it's very, very unique. Okay, let's move on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yay, next product.
Yes, yes, yes. 次はですね、
はい、
その芋焼酎をベースに山椒の風味を漬け込んだ、これも超スペシャリーな、スピリッツでございます。
So this is Sancho Spirit, everybody. It has imo, it's a imo shochu base, so a sweet potato shochu base with Sancho, which is this Japanese pepper.
はい。この、これは、このスピリッツはですね、まずその、芋焼酎を作ります。
Okay, so you first make sweet potato shochu.
それはあの、アルコール度数減収でだいたい401度とかそのぐらいだと思うんですけども、まず、
so undiluted, it's about 41% ABV.
で、そこに、だから、これでまず1回蒸留したものに対して、この自然の天然のですね、無農薬の山椒をそこに漬け込みます。
So to that distillate, you put the, so no...It's not, it's probably not certified organic, but it's an organic sancho pepper in it. And you soak it for a while.
はい。そして、その、蒸留したものはさらにその40何度より度数が高くなりますけども、その高い状態、これ何度かっていうのはちょっとあまり言えないんですけども、この40度より高いものに対して、またさらに、オーガニックの山椒を漬け込んで2回目のまた蒸留します。
漬け込んでからまた蒸留するんですよね。まず、
そうです、そうです。
芋焼酎を作って漬けて、それをまた蒸留して。
蒸留して。それで、そして、そうなんです。それでですね、結局3回蒸留してるんですよ、これ。で、最後、もう1回蒸留をして、で、そこの最初と最後をカットして真ん中のハートの部分だけを取ったのがこちらなんです。
Okay, so you make the potato shochu and then you soak this organic sancho peppers in it. You distill that and then you take that distillate and then put the, again, these organic sancho peppers in them. And then you distill it for the third time and then you...don't take the head or the tails and you just take the heart, so the middle part of the distillate, that's bottled in that product.
ですからこの生姜の風味、生姜じゃない、この山椒の風味がですね、本当にいろんなスパイスにもなるので、炭酸で割って飲むとまたいろんな料理とも相性が面白いですし、本当にこのここまで作るのにどれだけ手間がかかってるかっていうのを今日はこれを実際作っている この中原工場長が来てもらってますので、ちょっと中原さんにお話してもらいたいと思ってます。
はい。So, to show you how much labor goes into making this, he has invited Nakahara-san, who is the maker of this Sancho Shochu. So, Kimijima-san also was talking about how aromatic it is, and it is quite powerfully Sancho. He thinks it would be great if you cut it with some soda, and it goes really well with different kinds of foods. It's going to show you different impressions, and it great, amazing product. So we're going to have Nakahara-san join now and explain a little bit about what goes into making this. Nakahara-san, arigatou gozaimasu.
Hi.
Hi.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
はい、中原です。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。中原さん is joining us from this distillery in Kagoshima. はい。
中原さん、その、はい、蒸留機についてちょっと話してみてください。1回目は普通の焼酎の蒸留機だと思うんですけども、この最後の方に使う蒸留機が変わるじゃないですか。
はい。
Okay, so Nakahara-san is going to talk a little bit about the different stills that he's using for this triple distilled process. はい。はい。蒸留機は違うんですか ?1 回目と2回目と3回目。
そうですね。1回目は、まあ、普通の、芋焼酎作る工程で米麹作って、で、芋、さつまいもとスイートポテトで二次発酵して、したもろみを、まあ、日本の、まあ、ステンレスの蒸留機、乾式で蒸留します。それで芋焼酎の原酒を作りまして、で、まず、ちょっと今写真を見せますね。見えるかな？こういう。
これがそうですね。Okay, so the first process is with rice koji, and then they make the moromi, and then they add the sweet potato, and it's a kind of a more often used pot still.And that's the photo that he's for us. So you make the sweet potato shochu that way first. それが最初の、プロセスで、その原酒にオーガニックの山椒を。
そうですね。まあ、ジャパニーズペッパー、山椒ですね。こういった。
That's what 山椒 looks like. 山椒 pepper is used for like unagi and has kind of a different aromatic. It's a cousin to a Sichuan pepper. こんなになんか黄緑色なんですね。
そうですね。これが生の、オーガニックの、まあ、山椒ですね。
So、これを fresh pepper.、
Yeah. これを芋焼酎の原酒につけまして漬け込んで。まあ、エキスを抽出ですね。で、
so、
抽出。
Soaking, they're gonna get all the essence out of the 山椒。
で、抽出したものを山椒ごと、この。
あ、この最初のと一緒。
最初のはね、もっと違う。いわゆる。
Oh, I'm so sorry. So the first one is a traditional one. The photo that he's holding up is.The second distillation that he does.
これグラッパ作る蒸留機ですよね。
そうですね。
イタリア製。It's the same as the distillation machine that they use for grappa and other spirits.
これで、まず蒸留して、山椒の香りが含んだ、まあ山椒のスプリッツをまず1回目蒸留して作ります。で、その山椒の香りがついた、またスピリッツに、さらにさっきのまた生のフレッシュな山椒を漬け込みまして、で、蒸留しまして、その香りの一番、山椒の香りの一番いい、ところのレンジのハートだけを、商品化してボトリングしてます。
So they distill it twice in that special distillation machine, the ones that's used for grappa and other things. They soak the sancho, the fresh sancho, organic sancho again the second time, and they just take the heart, so they don't take the first bit and the last bit of the distillate, and they just take the middle part, which is supposed to be the best premium, and they bottle that to capture like the most aromatic portion of it.
そうですね。まあ、そうですね。まあ、やっぱり、酵母が、発酵で作った香りっていうのは、すごくアルコールに密着してるんですけども、まあ、漬け込んで、後から漬けた香りって結構、後から飛びやすいんで、まあ、それを、まあ、蒸留の工程でしっかり、いい香りをアルコールにし、まあ、しっかりつけるっていうのが、まあ、蒸留の工程だったので
染み込ませるね、
はい、それがやっぱりそのいい香りを、まあ、フレーバースピリッツを作る時の、まあ、テクニックっていうか技術になりますね、蒸留の技術になると思います、
はい、So I think using the abundance of this really fresh organic sancho、and doing it twice、is their way of capturing the aroma that is so important to them. Because he says that from the fermentation, the flavors can transfer well into the distillate, but when it's infused, it is harder to capture the flavor. So in order to get the maximum from this fresh sancho, I see the photos in the slides now of the sancho, they've gone this far to capture that essence to provide to you.
Nakara さんもやっぱりソーダ割りとかがで飲みますか？それとも飲み方とかは？
はい、そうですね。やっぱりまあ、ソーダ割りで、まあ、ちょっと度数を低めにして、まあ、食中で、例えば日本だと焼き鳥ですね。焼き鳥に合わせたりとか、当然もちろん、まあ、うなぎ、和食合うんですけど、
うなぎ、うなぎ最高ですよ。
うなぎ最高ですね。で、特にうな重、うな丼ですね。ご飯の上にうなぎ乗っけてるやつなんかは、これのお湯割りがすごく美味しいです。
So he recommends it with soda. That's a nice way to cut the alcohol percentage a little lower. You can have it with unagi, so eel that's grilled in the summer. You can also have it with hot water, oyuwari, just really nice. That sounds amazing because sancho does go well with unagi. It's often like sprinkled on top. We just had that Zoom where Ida-san hosted the Shibumi bento pairing thing. So we know that, we learned that in that. That sounds amazing. I did not think to pair it with unagi. Unagi no mae wa nan deshitakke?
Yakitori.
Yakitori da! Yakitori, like... the skewered chicken, which you can find all over Japan, having it with yakitori, he recommends, and that sounds amazing to me. Thank you.
And we actually have a question in the chat, again from Mark. Okay. On average, what is the percentage of mash to distillate?
Mash to distillate? 発酵してる状態の芋焼酎のアルコールは20度ぐらいですかね。何度ぐらいですかね。
そうです。まあ、もろみは、20度ぐらい、20度ぐらいで、それを蒸留して、初流と末だれ、まあ、ヘッドとテールをカット。 として原酒がだいたい40度前後です。
もろみ何キロに対して原酒どのくらいできます？例えばもろみ10キロに対して何キロの原酒ができます？だいたいでいいです。すいません。
まあ、大体、半分の5キロぐらいですね。
So, first to answer Mark's question,、the fermentation mash has about 20% ABV. And then when they distill it and cut the head and the tail and just take the heart、without diluting, so as a genshu, it's about 40% ABV. And then Ueno-san's question was how much of the distillate can you get from, let's say, 10 kilograms of、the mash? He said about half, so like 5、kilograms out of a 10 kilogram mash. Were there any other questions? Okay. Dira-san in、Chicago is having...うな丼tonight。シカゴでうなぎ丼今日食べる方がいるので、あったって言ってましたね。
まあ、あとこの普通にですね、この食後酒としてそのちょっとですね、このちょっとその食後酒として飲むとこのまたいっぱいお腹いっぱいのその満腹のところをうまくこういう消化していただけるのが、まあこれもやっぱり食後酒としての醍醐味ではないかと思いますね。
So, Kimijima-san also recommends it as a digestive after the meal、to enjoy and kind of、it's kind of like お疲れ様でした for your stomach after having a meal, just giving it a little break.、so, please enjoy it also as a digestive.、sit down with it, have some moments.
社長が今来ましたね。ちょっと社長、マスク取ってください。マスク取ってください。マスク。マスク取ってます。
こんにちは。
こんにちは。こんにちは。
あの、上流期、上流期クレイジーです。
Oh, he is the, the distillation, pot crazy president saying hi to us.
いや、君島さんはさっき間違えて僕に電話して。
We were trying to coordinate this before the event, and Kimijima-san was calling the president by accident.
いつも間違えた、しょうがない。
そっくりでしょ、そっくりでしょ。
そっくりそっくり。
Thank you for joining us.
ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございました。
どうもありがとうございました。どうも、すいません。っていうね、こういうすごい全 3人それぞれ違うんですけど、やっぱりこのたかが焼酎、されど焼酎、やっぱり焼酎って言っても本当に良さも違いますし、でも普通に飲む焼酎もいいんですよ。だからいろいろあっていいんですよね。だからこういうのばっかりがいいわけでもないし、やっぱり普通にあのだれ飴って疲れた時にお湯割りで飲む焼酎も素晴らしいですし、ですからこのいろんなシチュエーションをに合わせて行かれるといいんではないかと思っております。
So the shochu that's most popular in Japan is about like 20% ABV. That's the most drunk everywhere、in Japan. These three products, of course, are very unique, amazing products that、he would love for everybody to try to know the range of shochu, what it really can be.、and how amazing of a product it can be.、but really, he just wants you to enjoy that,、that sip, sit down,、have it、with a meal or after a meal.、would love for you to enjoy, like, not just like the incredible range, but also something that is available to you、that you can grab.
Thank you, 社長。
ありがとうございます、君島さん。
ありがとうございます。
中原さん、山川さん。
ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございました。
Are we going on to the cocktail portion?
Yeah, yeah. You know, being supported by this sponsor, Kuramoto USA is been sponsoring us with ice from Kanaza. So, you know, he just started this business from this year. And his name is Naoto Yonezawa. And he's going to give us, he's going to present us with a cocktail made from the shochu we just introduced. So here you go, Naoto-san. You ready? He's coming. You know, it's a Japanese premium pure ice. So, you know, many of Japanese bartenders use this, and it's new. And so he's going to show us that cocktail with his special ice from Japan.
All right. Thanks so much for the introduction. Thank you, everyone. Again, my name is Naoto, and I'm the only Japanese ice company selling imported ice from Japan. And one disclaimer, I'm not a bartender. So whatever I do, I'll try my best. And you know, I have so much respect into the producers, especially, you know, the producers here. I'm kind of intimidated because, you know, mixing it is sometimes rude to producer, but hopefully it will help get, you know, shochu and kusu, Aomori, more popular in the US. So what I want to do with Sakura Yamakawa Koshu Kusu, since it's very high-end, it has very rich, nutty aroma and finish to it, I don't want to mess with it too much. I don't want to mix with, you know, much with other stuff. So I want to do Japanese-style highball. You know, highball is very commonly drunk in Japan, but in the US, it's getting popular, especially in New York, LA. We recently see like highball machine provided by Suntory. So I believe highball made with Aomori is it called Shimaboru? Shimaboru って日本で結構あるんですかね? Is it something common in Japan?
シマボールって結局泡盛を炭酸割りのことですよね。
はい、そうです。
あると思います。
結構一般ですか。
ただ名前でそういう名前を使ってるかどうかっていうのは分かんないですけど、一般的には結構あります。はいはいはい。
I see. ありがとうございます。So, 泡盛 is I guess called 島酒 in 沖縄。So the name came from like 島 came from 島酒 means 泡盛 and ball came from highball.So highball is very simple, but you know, Japanese style is a little bit more refined, especially if you go to, you know, high-end cocktail bars in Japan. So, you know, you want to start with nice stick ice, nice clear ice with highball glass.
Oh.
So it's completely clear ice. So it's very nice. Mm. One single ice, which is very important because visually it looks nice.And also the carbonation loss comes from touching the ice. So if you have so many pieces of the ice in your glass, you lose the carbonation right away. So, you know, you want to do with like nice long ice. All right. And of course, Sakura Yamakawa Kusu. And so how much we should put on the cocktail?I would say 1.5 ounce to 2 ounces. If you want to go boozier, then you know, you can do 2 ounces, but for now, I would do 1.5. Okay. 1.5 of Sakura Yamakawa. And then when you pour carbonated water, sparkling water,try not to just pour it so fast. You should pour always from the side of the glass so you don't lose the carbonation. Carbonated water is actually very delicate. And the reason, another reason that I chose highball is that with clear spirits, I can show off how clear the ice is. It's almost invisible.
Oh.
If you pull it up,You see the ice, if you put in the cocktail, it's invisible. And another point is that when you stir it, you don't want to stir it too hard because you lose the carbonation again. So, you know, what most of bartenders in Japan do is just use simply lift the stick ice, pull it back, and just give it a gentle stir, and that's it. Okay. And for this cocktail, you know, I chose Goya bitter melon as a garnish because it's from Okinawa. Mm-hmm. So it has nice cucumber. It's kind of between cucumber and raw pumpkin, raw kabocha. So you can just simply put on top of this. And it's optional. If you're using high-end Kusu Aomori, I think this is already a nice cocktail. But if you want to add some citrus bitter or umami bitter, for this I wouldn't add, but it's going to add some richness and savoriness and salinity. Yeah. So that's the one. Next, okay. Next. Okay, I wanna play around with Sancho spirits. Since this is strong, even with, you know, Western style cocktail. So earlier, since Sakura Yamakawa is very high end, and you know, I didn't wanna kill the characteristic of it. I chose to make a highball, but for Sancho spirits, even if you mix with anything, you can still feel the Sancho, because as producer mentioned, the Sancho aroma is attached to the spirit so much. Even if you mix it, if you shake it, you can still get a lot of Sancho. It's very strong, but not aggressive in that sense. But so for this, you know, I want to use nice large block of Kuramoto ice. And since this is a chance for me to promote, I'll just do ice emboss and I'll leave a logo on the ice. Okay. So big rock glass, old fashioned glass. And mixing glass. And just add a few. So I'm doing it in this setting. I'm sitting down, so I can't really do it too fast, but. And these are also Kuramoto. It's nice and clear. It dilutes very slowly and it has no off flavor. Okay. So for this, I just want to play around with this. So I will do Spanish Farmers Rosso. Mm-hmm. And California Amaro, since I'm in California, I'm in LA, so this is made in California. So it has a lot of citrus notes. So Sancho, when I smell it, I get a lot of citrus notes. So I wanted to pair it with citrus. And since it's very high in proof, I wanted some sweetness from vermouth. And then also I wanted on the rock. I could do without the ice, but after I stir it, it's gonna be like probably 25% alcohol. So it's pretty high proof cocktail. So I wanted to serve on the rock. So I would do about 1.5 ounce. Of Sancho spirits. And you could do 1 ounce, but I like the balance with just 0.75 ounce of the vermouth, because it sometimes overpowers, depends on what kind of vermouth you use. And Amaro Angelino. It has a lot of like orange California citrus. So I like to drink it on the rock. Just a little bit to add some citrus note and sweetness. And then just stir it. And when you use high-end hard ice, like caramel ice, you should stir a little bit longer because it's not going to dilute that fast. And it actually chills a little bit slower. So you have a little more time to get everything mixed up. And of course, ice emboss should be ready. So we have a nice logo on the ice. Okay. And then we just add the ice on the old fashioned glass. And then just pour it. I like to pour it from the side because if you pour into the ice, you change the shape of the ice. Okay. And if you need to garnish, if you're in a restaurant setting, garnish is very important. You already have citrus notes, so it's not 100% necessary, but you can do a little bit of orange peel to add extra citrus to it. And by the way, in Japan, when you use orange peel or any peel, they normally don't put it in your drink because it's gonna overpower the drink. But in this setting, you know, I'm doing more Western style, American style cocktails, so I think we can just put it in there. And when I smell, I smell a lot of orange oil from the zest, but when I drink it, I get a lot of Sancho. So I think this product is very unique, and a lot of bartenders in the US would be interested a lot.
Okay. Wow, thank you so much. They look beautiful. They sound delicious. Shout out to Naoto-san from Kuramoto Ice. Thank you so much for demonstrating those two cocktails.
Oh, the other way around. Thank you.
I love that the ice is just so clear. It's kind of like magic. It's like a magic trick.
Oh, here is information, Kuramoto Ice USA. Contact is info@ice-kuramoto.com. And here is his number, 626-250-2078 is phone number. So that's that. Thank you, Naoto-san, for this presentation and being
Thanks
a sponsor
so
for all four sessions on this ice. We appreciate it. So now we're going to have quiz. Quiz. So it's a quiz time. So we're going to have four questions, multiple choice questions. Select the correct answer for each question and need to answer why the music is playing. Correct answer will be announced at the end of the next song after our guest and host last goodbye. And also we will put out that recipe. We Naoto just made the cocktails on our website, so you can take it from there. And the music we're gonna play is coming from Kimijima-san's song. And hold on. Where is it? Hold on. I am trying to get that.
What's the song called?
It's a Shochu Paradise. Hold on, I'm trying to get that one. Come on.
Come on.
So there's no music to distract you guys right now, but the quiz is going. And this is a chance to win the Shochu Advisor course for free, of course. So please, please participate and you might win. There's also a possibility that we might be choosing two winners from this round, as the last winner has not responded to our any of our contact attempts. So if you're kind of feeling discouraged, just try and guess anyways. This is a chance for you to win the Shochu Advisor class. Give it a shot. You never know what'll happen.
Ida-san, can you hear the music? Oh. ディフィカルティがありまして申し訳ないです。
Yes.
じゃあ、
ですね。I would also really like Uno-san to show us his shirt. It says Mystic Waters. That is the name of the band that Kimijima-san is in.
Yeah. Hold on. That's that.So now, oh, Kimijima-san is ready, and you know, you finished the quiz. So before we're gonna show you some slides, and I'd like to welcome Kimijima-san for his song, you know, created by himself, and this is a live unplugged. He's going to play acoustic guitar instead of the electric guitar. And the name is Ponchuga Saiko. And Sachiko-san can translate Ponchuga Saiko means.
Ponchu generally refers to any Japanese alcohol. A lot of times, Nihonshu or sake. But it's basically saying sake is awesome. Including shochu, because sake refers to any kind of alcohol in Japanese.
じゃあ、社長、一曲、一発。
いきますか。はい。
よろしくお願いします。
いきます、じゃあ。今日はありがとうございました。本当にコロナ世界中で流行ってもう本当にみんなが落ち込んでいるんですけども、やっぱりそのこういう状況を打破するのはやっぱりもう元気の出るお酒と元気の出る音楽しかないので、では今週が最高言っています。短くめに。初めから本州に決めてた室賀のやつにサンペレ入れて、今日はビールはいらねえ、ロックで行くぜ、今日はビールはいらねえ、ロックで行こうぜ。それが俺らの生きる道さ。今週が最高、今週が最高、今週が最高。この時代に戦ってる場合じゃねえよ、常に平和を考えていろよ、武器はいらねえ、グラスを持とうぜ、武器を捨ててさあグラスで乾杯、さあ乾杯さあ。今週が最高、今週が最高、今週が最高。今週が最高、今週が最高、今週が最高。
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.ありがとうございました。Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kimijima-san. Thank you so much. And Kimijima-san, 最後に一言なんか、クロージングの。
はい。あ、今日は本当にありがとうございました。焼酎、本当に日本でも結構今、ちょっとその焼酎の良さがちゃんと伝わってない感じがあるので、やはり、これだけのいいものですから、やっぱり皆さんに飲んでいただきたいなと思ってます。あとやっぱり世界中が今こんな状態で、やっぱりこういう気持ちもですね、本当になんかちょっと苦しい状況ですけども、そんな時にやっぱり助けてくれるのはこの 本当に美味しいお酒で、特にこの焼酎だと思いますので、ぜひ皆さんこれをきっかけにでそのこのいいお酒でですね、そのいい焼酎で、いいワインで、アルコールでね、いいお酒でね、乗り越えていきたいと思いますので、みんなで乗り切っていきたいと思います。今日はどうもありがとうございました。
どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。So, Kimijima-san says, oh, even in Japan, shochu often is misunderstood, he feels like, and the real amazing qualities of it doesn't get through. So his wish is that we all get through this pandemic and these hard times with a really good bottle of shochu in your hand or any other alcohol that's going to give you that companion that we all need. So thank you for joining us. I think the answers are coming up. Is that what's going on?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Sounds like
it. So before that, we have some announcement. So thank you, Kimijima-san, for understanding our intention with this project and supporting this. And also huge thanks to everybody participating in this seminar. Now we are, you know, at the same time, we are very proud that all of us got together and keep this project going. And this is not final, but for this season, this is the last one. And also appreciate people joining this Zoom seminar. Before revealing the quiz answers, there are several important announcements in the following slide with about 4 minutes music. First one is a Discovery Channel producer is looking for master distillery on shochu. Three contestants that they're looking for. Requirements are that you can make shochu in front of people, in front of the camera, and he doesn't have any distribution in the US yet. So if you know someone, or if you're gonna challenge it, I think you should. And I'm going to next slide. So these are the information, and you can, you know, as I said, it's they're looking for a master distiller for shochu, and this is the information and contact names here, and you directly email them. There is a two information here. You can take a photo of this, and you can apply for it. And here's last winner, Mark Goldberg, was a winner for 18th of June. Second was Kara Kansak-san, and last one was Taka Amano-san. Congratulations. And future Shochu Rocks, I'm hoping we'll come back on August. And these are the next classes we're gonna have. Certified Shochu Advisor Online, WCT Level Sake, 3 Sake in Texas, JSA Sake Diploma Online, which is Kimijima-san is vice president there, and he's the one that introduced me to the association. And Certified Sake Advisor Online, and here is our answer for the quiz. Ta-ta-ta. I didn't play the music this time because it was just too much for me to handle doing everything together, and I'm not really good tech guy. So here is answer. What is the name of the shochu song that Satoshi Kimijima produced? Was Shochu Paradise? Yay! And what is the Japanese term used for aged aomori in Okinawa is? Sachiko-san, pronunciation please.
Kusu?
Okay. And what is the rice polish ratio for Meiji Hatoka shochu from Kuma region? Was 100% because it's a brown rice. And which prefecture is Akayane Sancho shochu produced in? Of course, it's a sweet potato base. So Kagoshima was the answer. And thank you everyone for listening to this session. And Kimijima-san, どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
And keep tuning in for next one. We will still continue to do it. Okay. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye.
Also, thank you to Nakahara-san, Yamakawa-san for joining us. Yes.
Thank you.
ありがとうございます。
Thank you.
We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.